We will now start with our session. And for this session, I would now like to introduce the panel for our pre-lunch session. The presiding chair for the session is Dr. John Menachery. As the principal of MSS Institute of Social Work, Dr. Menachery has spent a large part of his life dedicated towards social causes and has held important places on the boards of various institutions, spearheading various initiatives working towards social initiatives and empowerment of people. I would now like to invite our chair, Dr. John Menachery, to open this session. May we please have a round of applause for him.
See, I just want to focus on the Food Corporation of India. The Food Corporation of India, which was founded in 1965, is an organization which has been formed under the Food Corporations Act. Now, these are aspects which has not actually been discussed. So I thought I'll just share it with you. And it is in every district in India, there is a branch of the Food Corporation of India. It is mandated to implement certain objectives. Four objectives it is supposed to do. One is price support operations. Second is distribution of food grains through the PDI, that is public distribution system. And then maintaining level of operational and buffer stock and regulate marketplace price. This is what the Food Corporation is mandated to do. And they have been doing a wonderful service, of course. It's the largest supply chain management in Asia and the second one, the largest in the world. Each year, the FCI purchases roughly 15 to 20% of India's wheat output and 12 to 15% of its rice output at government decided MSP, minimum support price. There is no limit for procurement in terms of volume. Any quantity can be procured by FCI, provided that the stock satisfy, there is something called fair average quality. It has also ventured into procurement of pulses from 2015-16, when the dal prices were going haywire. They started procuring pulses also. So that is an addition to wheat, rice, and now pulses also. It maintains many types of depots, like food storage depots and buffer storage complexes, and also private equity godowns. It has the latest storage methods of silo storage facilities in Hapur and Elawur. These are two silo facilities they have created. They are supposed to create more. The stocks are transported throughout India and issued to the state government nominees at the rates declared by the government of India for further distribution under the public distribution system. But all their supply will go into the PDS, public distribution system. It's not for open market. The difference between the purchase price, sale price, along with internal cost, etc., are reimbursed by the union government in the form of food subsidy. At present, the annual food subsidy is around $10 billion. That is the food subsidy of India. Some of the headlines that reflect the main issues of the FCI, that is what I wanted to share with you. This is one headline: Punjab's problem of plenty, bumper wheat crop, but no storage space. Now, this is a major crisis insofar as food wastage is concerned. Rot destroys thousands of quintals of rice meant for poor. Grain worth crores meant for poor missing from FCI godown. Grain from FCI godown reaches open market. It is not supposed to reach open market. It's only for the public distribution system. Wasted food grains ends up as manure. And wasted food grain ends up at beer making units. Now, this is one picture of how they store their grains when there is the harvest season, when they start actually procuring. Many of their godowns are insufficient capacity-wise, and therefore they store it in the open, covered with some kind of a plastic. And then when the rains come, most of it will get wet and it is then wasted. There is a possibility, I'm just saying it's a possibility, there's a nexus between the alcohol lobby and the food corporation, so that enough number of godowns are not created, enough silos are not created scientifically to preserve what is being procured. So thousands and thousands of kilos of food grains are this way wasted, and it goes into beer manufacturing and fertilizer manufacturing and so many other things. There is an urgent need to embark on advocacy for augmenting grain storage facilities of FCI. Why Food Corporation of India is not increasing the number of godowns when they know that this much stock is to be kept every year? It's a recurring thing, it's not just 1 year, but it is not done. So there is a need for making this kind of a advocacy as part of our campaign, because I believe that larger issues are involved here. So these larger issues also should be addressed by this August gathering. Friends, I will come back once the presentations are over and try to make a summing up and after the three presentations. I am very happy that I am in the August company of three great people of this city. Mr. Asit Sinha is a kind of a teacher, because when I came to Nagpur, I was listening to some of his lectures and I was really inspired the way he conducts his classes. Farah is my student, and I'm very happy that a student of mine is here today. I feel very honored that there's a student here. Sulba, of course, she's a tigress. She looks she's a very green outfit, because she is an environmentalist fighting for the cause of the environment, animal rights, etc. So I'm very happy, as the person who introduced said, 15 minutes is allowed. Where is the bell? Where is the bell? So after 15 minutes, there will be a bell and you can wind up. But if you continue, then the rule is there will be no open discussion, and there will be so many bells, then I think the mic will be switched off. That will be the end. So I hope you all will stick to the time, and we all know that there is a kind of a time lag gap now because of certain delays that we had. We'll try to make up, but do make your presentation within the stipulated time so that we can have a beautiful discussion after your presentations. Thank you. We'll